بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا بالقاسم محمد والأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين واللانة الدائمة الباقية على أعدائهم من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يسألونك عن الشهر الحرام قتال فيه قل قتال فيه كبير صلوات الله عليه وسلم This is the first Thursday of this month and keeping in mind that we are getting close to the month of Rajab, which will start inshallah on Sunday. I began with the ayat from Surah Al-Baqarah, ayat number 217, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the important months. But before I come to the ayat itself, let me, as a theme, talk about this concept of sacredness in time and space. When we talk about time and space, we have to realize not every place is equal in the eyes of religion as far as their sacredness and importance is concerned. Neither is every time that we are in is equal to the other. If you look at the time, for example, the dawn, the fajr is considered to be more important than the other times of the days. Even this scenery of Jannah, when you see, it's more or less like Fajr. There is light, but there is no sunlight. And so that's, you know, the Fajr would be more preferred and a more blessed timing than the other times. When you look at the days, for example, of the week, not every day is equal to the other. Friday has its own importance and sacredness. And that's where we see Thursday, from sunset all the way to Friday sunset, is considered to be more holier and sacred than other days of the week. Even when we talk about space, in your own home also, you know, people sometimes have this habit of putting their musalla in one place, whether it's in their own bedroom or the living room or wherever, to do their namaz. So that area becomes like a musalla for themselves. And that area is considered to be more important than others. For example, if you look at the rulings about you know, people who are going through the last moments of their life, sakaratul maut, we are told that if that person is still going through the pains and agony of the death at that moment, take that person and place him in the place where he used to do namaz. That will relieve him from that pain. So it means that area of the house is more sacred than other areas. Or even when we look at a masjid, you know, in a neighborhood you have different places, you have school, hospital, houses, shops, you know, and then there is a masjid. Of course, masjid as a space would be more sacred than all other areas in the neighborhood. So when we look at that concept, that not every time and space is equal to the other. When you look at the Islamic calendar, the question comes up, are all months equal to the other? No. And this is where we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Baqarah at number 217, he responds to the question that the people had asked the Prophet. Because even during the time of the Jahiliyyah, there were certain months which were considered to be more sacred, where warfare was not allowed. Nobody will initiate an attack on anyone. And those were the months where the Arabs, even if they were bitter enemies of one another, would still respect the sanctity of that month and not harm the other person. And so the question was, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ قِتَالٍ فِيهِ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Muslims are asking you about the Shahr al-Haram, the holy month or the sacred month, about qital fihi, about initiating war in that month. Qul qitalun fihi kabir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to do qital and have a, you know, warfare in that month of Shahrul Haram is a serious, you know, violation of Allah's laws. Now, what are the Shahrul Haram or Ashhurul Hurum? All the Muslims are unanimous. There is no dispute on this issue that there are 4 months of the Islamic calendar. You have Zilqad, Zilhajj, and Muharram. So the 11th month, the 12th month, and the following first month of the next year. So these 3 months together become the sacred month. But then there is 1 month left aside by itself, and that is the month of Rajab. So you have Zilqa'da, Zilhijjah, Muharram, and the month of Rajab. These 4 months in the Islamic calendar are considered to be sacred months. And this is where we see that, you know, especially if you look at the 3 months together, Zilqa'da, Zilhijjah, Muharram, they are in a way linked to the process of Hajj, before it and after it. But Rajab is there by itself, alone. And it has its own, you know, importance. And this is where we have to come to realize that, you know, the month of Rajab has its own significance from the spiritual point of view. And this difference that you see in the hours and the days and the nights and the months, it's not only a phenomenon of space and time. Even our own spiritual, you know, dimension, the spiritual heart, not this physical heart. The spiritual heart also is not always on the same status of spirituality. You know, the master of all spiritual masters, Amir al-Mu'minin Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wasalam, is a beautiful statement, a very short statement where he says, "Inna lil qulub iqbalan wa idbaran." He says, even your spiritual heart goes through ups and downs. Iqbal and idbar. Iqbal means it moves forwards, and idbar means it moves back. So you have up and downs. You know, sometimes it is high, sometimes it is low, as far as the spiritual levels are concerned. And this is where we come to realize it's not only the issue of space and time, even psychologically, human beings are not always on the same level. And then Ali says, remember, when you are spiritually at a higher level, and your heart is with you, helping you to attain higher levels, then maximize that element and that time, and do the extras that you can do. And when your spiritual heart is going back, it is at a lower level, then Ali says, make sure at that time you are able to at least do what is wajib, if not the extras. And so we have to seize the moment when we find ourselves to be in the state of a higher spiritual level. You know, do the maximum that we can do, but if we are sometimes low down there, you know, then we still have to make sure we do what is wajib and refrain from what is haram. Salawat man ek par aur. Now, if you look at the month of Rajab, it is very important from the spiritual perspective. If we divide the calendar or the year into seasons, you know, normally we say 3 months, you know, is one season. If you look at it from that perspective, if I am to identify 3 months where I would label it as the spiritual season of Islamic calendar, I would say it is the months of Rajab, Sha'ban, and Ramadan. These 3 months together, basically they constitute the spiritual season of the Islamic calendar. And Rajab is the beginning. And that is why if you look at the books like Mafatihul Jinan or any other book of Aa'mal and things like that, in the section of rituals, special rituals that we do, You will see it doesn't start with Muharram. Muharram is the first month of our calendar, but it doesn't start with Muharram and then Safar and then Rabiul Awwal. It starts with Rajab. Why? Because this spiritual new year, beginning of this spiritual season in the Islamic calendar, is with the month of Rajab. Salawat on Akbar. The names given by the Prophet to this month are also very reflective of that reality. He says, this is known as Shahrul Istighfar. This is the month where, forgiveness should be there quite a lot, and Allah will forgive. In the hadith that he has, he says, Rajab Shahrul Istighfar li Ummati. Rajab is the month of forgiveness for my Ummah. Akthiru fihi al-istighfar. Maximize this process of asking for forgiveness, because Allah is a Ghafoorul Rahim. And then he says the next month, Sha'ban Shahri. And Sha'ban is my month. And in that month, what should you do? Increase salawat on me and my family. Wa Ramadan Shahrullah. And Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in there, you have to maximize the glorification and worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even the Prophet in this hadith has connected Rajab and Sha'ban and Ramadan to the spiritual dimension of our own, development. Another name that we see the hadith, Rajabul Fard, means Rajab the lone one by itself. Means if you look at the four months which are the sacred months, Zilqad, Zilhajj, Muharram are together, Rajab is separate, it's by itself. Another name is Rajabul Asad, the month where the blessings of Allah come in abundance. And a fourth name is Shahru Amir al-Mu'mineen. Rajab is the month of Ali. There is a hadith where he says, and it goes with this hadith of the Prophet, where Ali says that Rajab is my month, Sha'ban is month of Rasulullah, and Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a symbolism there. You had to go to Ali to reach to Rasul, and you had to go to Rasul to reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salawat on Akbar. Just one more hadith from our seventh Imam, since I'm talking about the month of Rajab. The word Rajab itself is the month of name of this month, but it's also name of a stream in Jannah, where the Imam says, Ashaddu biyadan min al-laban, more whiter than the milk, wa ahla min al-asal, more sweeter than honey. Man sama yawman min Rajab, whoever fasts one day in Rajab, Allah will serve him the drink from that stream known as Rajab. Salawat upon the Akbar. So basically, I want to take this opportunity to remind myself and you of the importance of this month, which is coming, inshallah, starting on Sunday. And some of the things which have been recommended by our Imams. Just a reminder, mashallah, you know all these things, but this is for myself as well as a reminder for you. Fasting has been very much emphasized during this month. For example, there is one hadith says, if somebody fasts the first 7 days of Rajab, because spirituality and fasting go hand in hand, you really have to give up your physical desires in order to strengthen and awaken your spiritual element. And so if somebody fasts for 7 days, first 7 days of the month of Rajab, the hadith says, غُلِقَتْ عَنْهُ سَبْعَةَ أَبْوَابِ النَّارِ. The seven gates of Jahannam will be closed to him. So he will be away from it. And if you add one more day and fast for 8 days, first 8 days of the month of Rajab, فُتِحَتْ لَهُ ثَمَانِيَةَ أَبْوَابِ الْجِنَانِ. There are 8 gates to Jannah. Those 8 gates will be opened for somebody who fasts the first 8 days of Rajab. And if you make it all the way to 15th, from 1st to 15th, now you will say, you know, we have a problem with Ramadan, now you're asking us to fast for what? Wait, hold on, we're just 15, we still more to go. If you fast first 15 days, the hadith says, a person who fasts for first 15 days of Rajab, his wishes will be granted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially when we talk about 27th of Rajab, the day of Mi'raj, the day where the revelation of the Quran started, the day where the Prophet went to the heavens. You know, this is a very important day, and if you fast on that day, the hadith says that fasting on that one day, the thawab and reward would be equal to fasting for 60 years. It doesn't mean if you have a qaza of 60 years, you do it one day. No, that's a different thing. This is just showing the level of thawab. You know, fasting that one day is almost like fasting for 60 years. And then, of course, there are hadiths which says that if you fast for the whole month of Rajab, then that person would be released from the fire of Jahannam, and his wishes will be granted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, provided he has the iman and refrains from the major sins during that entire month. So those are the two conditions for that. You shouldn't be surprised to hear that, you know, when we talk about fasting for the whole month of Rajab, or even later on for the whole month of Sha'ban, connecting it to Ramadan, which is wajib anyway. I know of people who do that. So it's not something, you know, unusual in that way. Yes, it is not that normal, but, you know, this is there as far as the process of attaining higher spiritual levels. Let me clarify one thing here. According to the fatwa, when we talk about this fasting during the month of Rajab or Sha'ban, if you have qaza fasts, then you cannot do sunnah fast. So what do? You then do the fasting with the niyat of qaza, but during those days, 7 days or 8 days or 15 days, all on 27th of Rajab, you know, you do the niyat of qaza, but because you are doing it on those days when it has been recommended, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not niggardly. He will give you reward for the qaza as well as for the sunnat fasting that you are doing, provided you have that intention in mind that, you know, you are doing it qaza because qaza is wajib on you, but you are doing it during the days when it was recommended by our ma'sumeen. Salawat. Of course, there are special amal also during the month of Rajab. The first Thursday night is known as Laylatul Raghaib, the night when the wishes of individuals are accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Raghaib is from raghabat, you know, something that you desire or you wish for. And you had to fast on that first Thursday. So we are talking about next Thursday, next week. And after Maghrib and Isha, there are amal in Mafati. Inshallah, we'll be doing it after the program, after Maghrib and Isha, next week. Then, of course, we have 13th to 15th of Rajab, which is recommended to fast, and then do amal of Dawood. Of course, if you look at the narration, the way it has come down, this is basically for a special hajat that an individual would have, or a serious problem that they are going through. And, you know, after fasting for these 3 days, on the 15th, you do the Amal of Dawood after the Zuhr time. And of course, on the 1st and the 15th and the last day of Rajab, it is recommended to recite Namaz-e-Salman Farsi, which is there in Mafatihul Jinan also. And finally, one of the things recommended in Rajab is to go for Umrah. Umrah done in the month of Rajab is almost equal to the reward of doing Hajj. Salawat. From the historical point of view, the month of Rajab is also very significant, but because there are so many events linked to the lives of the Masumeen regarding the month of Rajab. You have the events of Viladat of 5th Imam, Wafat of 10th Imam, Viladat of the 9th Imam, of course the Viladat of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Then on the 15th of Rajab you have the occasion where the Qibla was changed from Jerusalem to Mecca, and that's also the day where we commemorate the Wafat of Bibi Zainab. And then we have Wafat of the 7th Imam and of Hazrat Abu Talib also, and the event of Mi'raj and Bi'sat, which occurred on the same day. And of course at the end we have this commemoration for the beginning of the journey of Imam Hussain alayhi salam. So it is a month which is not only on a personal spiritual level, it's a very important month, but also from the historical perspective. If you look at our calendar, you will see probably this is, besides Muharram, Safar and Ramadan, this will be almost a full month with activities and programs going on in our centers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to maximize the blessings of this coming month of Rajab, inshallah. Maha Rajab ke recommendations mein ek ahem masala jo Imam Jafar Sadiq alayhi salam ne bayan kiya hai. وہ زیارت امام حسین ہے پہلی رجب کو. یعنی اگر ممکن ہے کہ انسان پہلی رجب کو کربلا پہنچے امام حسین علیہ السلام کی زیارت کے لیے, امام ششم فرماتے ہیں منظر الحسین بن علی علیہ السلام فی اول رجب غفر اللہ له البتہ. تو کوئی اگر امام حسین بن علی کی زیارت پہلی رجب کو کرے تو خداوند عالم اس کے تمام گناہوں کو معاف کرے گا. اگر انسان کربلا نہیں پہنچ سکتا ہے تو اگر وہ ان شہر میں ہے جہاں دوسرے معصومین کے مراقد و روزے ہیں, وہاں جائے اور وہاں پہ امام حسین علیہ السلام کی زیارت پڑھے, اور اگر وہاں بھی نہیں ہے جیسے ہم لوگ یہاں ہیں اتنا دور, تو پھر انسان دور سے پہلے رجب کے دن امام حسین علیہ السلام کی زیارت پڑھے, بہرحال ثواب اس میں بھی ملے گا. لیکن یہ انٹرسٹنگ بات ہے کہ رجب کی تاریخ میں جو واقعات کو ہم دیکھتے ہیں, 28 رجب امام حسین علیہ السلام کے سفر کا آغاز ہے, لیکن اسی مہینے میں 15 رجب کو جناب زینب کی وفات منائی جاتی ہے, اور اسی ایک مہینے میں جہاں حسین کا ذکر ہے وہاں زینب کا بھی ذکر ہے. عجیب بات ہے, پہلے رجب میں زیارت حسین ہے, 28 رجب میں سفر امام حسین ہے, اور 15 رجب میں جناب زینب کی وفات منائی جاتی ہے. اور اس سلسلے کو دیکھا جائے تو یہ بہت ہی انٹرسٹنگ ہے کہ زینب اور حسین کو کبھی بھی ہم ایک دوسرے سے الگ نہیں کر سکتے, خصوصاً اسی جو تھیم ہم نے شہر الحرام کے عنوان سے پیش کی ہے. امام حسین علیہ السلام کے حوالے سے ایک حدیث ملتی ہے امام علی بن مسر رضا علیہ الصلاۃ والسلام کی, جہاں پہلی محرم کو ابن الشبیب امام کی خدمت میں پہنچا اور امام نے کہا کہ یہ بتاؤ چاند نکل چکا ہے, پہلی محرم ہے آج؟ اس نے کہا ہاں یقیناً آج پہلی محرم ہے. پھر امام نے اس سے کہا کہ تم نے آج روزہ رکھا یا نہیں؟ پھر فرماتے ہیں کہ اے ابن شبیب, یہ ماہ محرم ان مہینوں میں سے ہیں جو خداوند عالم نے اسے الشہر الحرام میں قرار دیا ہے, جس میں جنگ کرنا, کسی کو قتل کرنا منع ہے. جاہلیت کے دور میں یہ جو غیر مسلم جو مشرک تھے, یہ بھی ان مہینوں کے حرمت کا خیال کرتے تھے, لیکن یہ مسلمان امت ہے جس نے نواسے رسول کے حرمت کا خیال نہیں کیا. حسین کا خون ان کے لیے محترم ہے, ماہ رمضان اپنے جگہ پہ محترم ہے, لیکن کس طرح سے ذبح کیا ہے. اس لیے جو عنوان ہے امام کا کہ ابن الشبیب ان کنت باکیا علی شیء, اے ابن الشبیب اگر تجھے رونا ہے کسی چیز پر, کسی انسان کی بات نہیں کی ہے, علی شیء کوئی بھی مصیبت اگر پڑی ہے, آدم سے لے کے خاتم تک اور آخر تک جو کچھ ہونے والے ہیں مصائب میں, اگر کچھ یاد کر کے رونا ہے, فبکا علی الحسین بن علی, تو تم حسین بن علی پر رو. کیوں؟ اس لیے انہ بوبحا کما یذبح الکبش, اس لیے کہ حسین کو ذبح کیا گیا جس طرح سے ایک دمبے کو ذبح کیا جاتا ہے. عزداران حسین ہمارے تمام امام میں سے 11 امام سب شہید ہوئے ہیں, اکثر زہر کے ذریعے. تلوار کی شہادت علی کو بھی ملی ہے, لیکن سر پر ضربت لگی تھی, کسی امام کا ان کی زندگی میں اور حیات میں سر کو تن سے جدا نہیں کیا گیا تھا. یہ صرف حسین ہے جو مذبوع ہے, جنہیں ذبح کیا گیا تھا, اور اس وقت وہاں کوئی نہ تھا جو روکتا کہ حسین کو ذبح نہ کیا جائے. بس ایک بہن تھی جو تلے زینبیہ پہ کھڑی تھی, وہاں سے نشیب کی طرف دیکھتی ہے حسین کے اس سینے پر شمر منحوس کا زانو تھا. عمر ابن سعد سے یہی کہتی ہے, اے عمر ابن سعد تو دیکھتا رہے گا اور میرا بھائی قتل کر دیا جائے گا. الا لعنت اللہ علی القوم الظالمین سیعلم الذین ظلموا ای منقلب ینقلبون. خداوند اس قلیل عباد قبول فرما, ہمارے گناہ کو بخش دے, ہماری توفیقات میں اضافہ فرما, ایمان کو ظہور میں تاجر فرما. ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع الحليم.